I am sure the knowledge and information that we will get during this event will be applicable to further enhance our capability in handling our daily responsibilities. Please do leverage the outcome of this event to further enhance the public service delivery, especially in the area of cyber security. Ladies and gentlemen, Intan has planned 6 events for digital hot trends this year. The main objective of these events is to enhance awareness and knowledge sharing on current digital trends. These events are an application of the Blue Ocean Online Strategy, or Blue Ocean Strategy, BOS, between Intan and digital industry players to disseminate effective knowledge sharing and learning on digital matters. In fact, on this note, I was just sharing with Admiral Walsh. Last year, on Blue Ocean Strategy alone, of course we have hundreds of programs online, but on Blue Ocean Strategy alone, last year we piloted 20,000 packs to undergo Blue Ocean contents of the training. And this year, because of that success, we are entrusted to increase ninefold to 180,000. So it's a big challenge for us to deliver that part of the service delivery. And obviously, in delivering that part, cybersecurity is key to ensure that our system is in full integrity in terms of protecting from any possible cyber disturbance. The theme of today's event is cyber intelligence. Make it real, make it happen.
So the key characteristics of this framework that we're describing is that it's team-oriented, that it has to work its way through ambiguity as well as fog and chaos. It's an immersive environment, and because it's immersive and because it's granular, it's high fidelity. And in order for it to be successful, it has to be cross-functional. And the reason why we feel comfortable describing this now as readiness, next generation education, training, and readiness, is because of the multiple sources of intelligence that we're using. So think of Intel as content. Our contextualized understanding of the adversary comes from the EyeSight model, which is the upper left part of the Venn diagram. EyeSight model is one where there's former law enforcement and former military from several countries around the world who are inside the darknet, who are collecting. And they're collecting inside a malware development cycle. So they understand the actor, they understand the motivation of the actor, and the history of that actor in terms of the attack surface that's used and the outcome that actor is trying to achieve. We combine that now with the victim intelligence that comes from those who are the first responders at Mandiant, our consultants. Because they have hands-on experience with customers who have been victims, they understand now what the breach environment actually looks like and what customers have to deal with, particularly when it comes to lesser-known sorts of malware and zero-day problems. And then finally, we have from the FireEye deployed sensors, we have the intelligence that comes back from the deployed network. When you put all that together, in our view, it's rich content that we use now to fuel our understanding of how to convey training and education and current forms of proficiency and currency in an environment that's changing. Now it's possible to discuss the architecture for moving something like this forward in a more formalized way. What I've described to you in terms of those team and that team approach is right in the middle. It's called operational integration. Notice the language that we're using here. It's language that's more focused on on readiness. Training and education is often viewed as discretionary, unfortunately, where in good budget years, we can actually push more people into seats for education and training. Readiness, however, is something completely different. Readiness gets at the core operating principles of a company or a government agency. And if we're not ready, then we take great risk in terms of stepping away from having a sharp edge and being ready to go each day that we're operating on the network. So our clients, our partners, have come back to us after those engagements that represent that middle area, that operational integration, and they say, well, what do we do in between? Because when we actually put ourselves in a pressurized environment, we realize we have shortfalls. That's when we go back to what we're describing here as tactical threat awareness, and we realize there's individual skills that we need to either refine or update or in some cases introduce.
To read malicious ICT security readiness, are we doing enough? And what should we do that we are not doing?
You may be kicked out from the room, so he must know how to answer us.
Honestly, I'm not in a position to evaluate malicious ICT readiness, but I think it's a question that, in order to answer it and to answer it honestly with a factually informed answer, we would need to do a baseline assessment of the team and to understand where their skills are. And so I think the best way to answer your question is to describe the process of how I can give you a conclusive answer. But it would have to be based on close observation data, evaluating the time to detect in a very in an emulated environment where we simulate your network, your tools, and to be able to evaluate how teams respond under pressure. We would take a look at the way that you detect and contain, and then be able to present some of the latest concerns that we see in the wild as far as malware and how your team reacts to that. That would be the way I would try and answer the question. And then from that, to be able to give you a way ahead that either reinforces incident response skills, help build a better, stronger understanding of intel analysis, or find other ways to be a partner with you as you move forward.